Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel. So I'm back with a Himachali recipe again. This time we are going to make a Himachali style khichdi. It's called Tudkiya Bhath. I hope I'm pronouncing it correct. If there's anybody from Himachal, please correct me if I'm wrong. So this is a very simple dish, a one pot dish that you can make. There are a few ingredients, but then the process is very simple. For the full ingredients list, please check the description box. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing and like and share my videos. So I'll tell you what needs to be done. So in here I've got basmati rice, which I have soaked for 30 minutes and drained and kept it ready. Here I've got whole masoor dal, the one with the outer cover. This I have soaked for 30 minutes, drained it and kept it aside. I've got some potatoes cut into batons and I've soaked it in water so that they don't brown. So these are the three main ingredients in the dish. Apart from this, we'll also need some curd. It has to be thick curd. Some sliced onions, cinnamon, bay leaf, black cardamom and green cardamom. Apart from this, we'll also have to make a paste out of star anise, mace, green cardamom, black cardamom, cinnamon, clove and a little bit of poppy seeds. To this we also need to add, while making the paste, one tomato, one onion, some coriander leaves, some ginger, garlic and green chilies. It might sound like there's a lot of ingredients in this, but this is a very simple dish to make. Apart from all of these ingredients, we'll also need a little bit ghee as the medium of cooking. So let's start making the dish. First step is to take the tomato, onion, coriander, green chili, ginger and garlic. To this add star anise, cinnamon, cardamoms, poppy seed and the clove and mace. Now I'm going to quickly use the mixer and grind this into a paste. So I've taken the potatoes in a different bowl. And I'm going to add the ground masala. It's a very fragrant masala. Almost feels like cooking a biryani. Mix the masala into the potatoes. Keep this aside for a while. I've got a deep pan pressure cooker on fire. Into that I'm going to add ghee. We'll let this heat up. Once it's hot enough, you add in the cardamom, bay leaf, cinnamon. Let it give out its aroma. Once that's done, add in sliced onions. Now we'll cook the onion till translucent. Onions are cooked till they are translucent. Now we're going to add the potatoes and the ground masala. Mix well and cook the masala for some time. We need to cook this masala until it gives out a good aroma and all the raw smell disappears. Now the masalas are cooked. I'm going to add the whisked curd into the mixture. Now you have to cook the curd until the oil separates. The curd is cooked and the oil has started oozing out. Now you add in the masoor dal. Mix it well. And follow it up with the rice. Again, give it a nice mix. And we're going to season this with salt. Add the salt and mix it again. I've measured 3 cups of hot water here. I'm going to pour that into this. Clear the sides. Now we're going to close it with the lid. On high, we're going to let this cook for 2 whistles. After the 2 whistles, do not open the pressure cooker. Let it cool down completely before opening it. I've already given out 2 whistles, so I've switched off the gas and I'm going to let this cool down completely. So the pressure is released fully and I'm going to open the pressure cooker now. I'm going to just use a fork to lightly fluff the rice. It's done and it's ready to serve. Serve this hot with any mashed dal curry or dal fry and raita. So this is a totally different recipe which you can try at your home. Do let me know how you found it. Thanks for watching my channel and I'll see you next time. Bye.